Dear Muslims, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in the Quran that He has created the creation in order to test us. In Surah Hud, Allah says, وَهُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى عَلَى الْعَرْشِ, that He is the one who created the heavens and earth in 6 days. وَكَانَ عَرْشُهُ عَلَى الْمَاءِ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا, to test you, لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ, who amongst you is best in their deeds. And in Surah Tabarak, Allah says, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا, He has created death and life to test you, who amongst you is doing the best of deeds. Twice in the Quran this phrase occurs, لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا, testing, examining whose deeds come out to be the best. Allah says He's created the whole creation to test you. Allah says He's created death and life to test you. So in today's brief khutbah, let us examine the parameters of this test. Because every test has certain aspects, certain elements. And in today's khutbah, we will analyze how is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala testing us. The parameters of a test are many. First and foremost, there must be somebody who is giving the test, somebody who's examining, somebody who will grade. There is no test without the one who grades. Who is grading this test? It is none other than Allah Jalla Jalaluhu. Allah Himself will take charge of assessing every single one of us. And who is Allah? He is Ar-Rahman, He is Ar-Rahim, He is Al-Ghafoor, He is Arhamur Rahimeen, He is Alimul Ghaybi wa Shahada. So Allah Azza wa Jal Himself, the one from whom no one can hide, and the one who is the most merciful of all who have mercy, He is the one who is in charge of our test. Sufyan al-Thawri, the famous scholar of hadith of the second century, he said, I would rather that Allah examine me on the Day of Judgment than even my mother or father, because Allah will have more mercy upon me than even my mother and father will. So the one who's examining us and the one who will test us, that is none other than Allah, the Arhamur Rahimeen. As well, when it comes to the test, in every test, there is someone that is being tested. There is the object of the test. And of course, in this creation, we, the human beings, are the ultimate object of test. And to a secondary level, the jinn as well. So the men and the jinn are the ones being tested. And tests are given to those who are qualified. What makes us qualified? How did we get to this? Allah Azza wa Jal gave us qualities that none of the other creation has. We have a sense of intellect and a sense of aql and a sense of faculties and perception that no other species has. And Allah tells us, وَلَقَدَ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي Adam. We have honored the children of Adam. We have given them what no other creation has been given. Even the angels have bowed down to us. So Allah Azza wa Jal has created us to be qualified for that test. And we have privileges and ranks and blessings and faculties that none of the other creation has. وَفَضَّلَكُمْ عَلَىٰ كَثِيرٍ مِّمَّنْ خَلَقْنَا تَفْضِيلًا. Allah says, I preferred you over many other creatures that I have created. Every test has a syllabus and it has a teacher. What is our syllabus and who is our teacher? Our syllabus is the Quran and our teacher is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we study the syllabus and we read the textbook and we listen to the teacher and we obey the teacher, then we shall pass the test without a shadow of a doubt. But if we turn our back on the syllabus and we don't care about the textbook and we don't pay attention to the teacher, well then what happens in any class to somebody who does that will be happening to us as well. Our Lord has sent down to us the most beautiful syllabus, the most powerful textbook, the most noble teacher. There is no teacher more noble than our teacher. There is no textbook more blessed than our textbook, and that is the Quran and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How is the test performed? In the tests of this world, we sit down typically and we do an examination. There's multiple choice or there's essays or something of this nature. How about the tests of this dunya? The exams of this world are tested in two different ways. The exams that Allah Azza wa Jal gives us, there are two primary categories of tests. The first of them is our adherence to the Sharia. And the second of them is how we respond to the calamities and the tribulations of this world. Our life conduct in this dunya is also a test. So these are the two genres of tests. Teachers give different types. Some give projects, some give multiple choice, some give this and that. The tests of this world that Allah has assigned upon us are two primary categories. Number one, our adherence to the sharia. Do we do what is wajib? Do we follow the wajibat? Do we abstain from that which is haram? What is our level of adherence to the sharia? That is one category of tests. The other category of tests, how do we respond to what happens to us? How do we respond to the good and the bad, to the positive and the negative? Allah tells us in the Quran, وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً. We're going to test you with good and with evil. Both of them are a trial for you. So when good happens, it is a test. When bad happens, it is a test. When we get a lot of money, it is a test. When we are poor, it is a test. Everything that happens to us, our response is measured and it comes under the test. So these are the two primary categories of tests. Number one, our adherence to the sharia. How much do we follow the syllabus? How much do we adhere to the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And number two, how do we react to what is happening around us? Are we patient? Are we thankful? Do we accept Allah's qadr? How is our attitude towards the daily events that happen around us? Now the other question that arises, generally speaking, the tests of this world, when the examiners come, generally speaking, everybody in the same room gets the same examination, and people of different levels get different exams. So the test of grade one is not that of grade two. The test of the undergraduate is not that of the graduate, but everybody at the undergraduate level gets the same test. How about us in this world? It is an amazing phenomenon of our tests that no two tests are exactly the same. No two tests of this world are exactly the same. On the contrary, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given every one of us a custom designed test. Every one of us is going to be given a test that is most suited for us. Can you imagine a professor will write different exams for different students so that he facilitates every student getting the maximum result? If a professor knows which student's weakness is this, which student's strength is that, and he then tests based upon the weakness and strength in order to make it easier for the student to pass. Can you imagine a professor like this? It doesn't exist in this world. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah azza wa jal, the creator, the khaliq, the bari, the musawwir, Allah azza wa jal has tested all of us with a unique, with an individual, with a custom-made test. No two human beings are given the same test. Why? Because Allah knows our strengths and weaknesses, and Allah knows what test to put on what people and what test to avert from other people. And every test that Allah has put upon us, He knows we can pass it. He knows we can score an A in it. He knows we have the capability to get the highest results if we choose to do so. Because Allah Azza wa Jal reminds us, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. Allah is not going to burden you with more than what you can bear. We are all doing custom-made tests. Allah tells us in the Quran, لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ فِيمَا آتَاكُمْ. He will test you in accordance with what you have been given. Not everybody has the same test. What you have been given, you will be tested in accordance with that. لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ فِيمَا آتَاكُمْ. So the one who has certain powers, certain talents, certain wealth is tested in a different way. The one who does not have those things is not tested in that way. Every person's test is unique and individually catered and custom made. How much easier do you want it to be when your Lord and Creator and my Lord and Creator has chosen for us the questions, knowing that these questions are the best for us to answer? This is the test that Allah Azza wa Jal has placed us in. How is the test recorded? Every test has proctors, has monitors. For us, we have kiram and katibin, ya'lamuna ma taf'alun. We have two proctors, the one on the right, the one on the left. Ma yalfidhu min qawlin illa ladayhi raqibun atib. We have two angels writing down every single matter and every single response throughout the day and night. We have the angels writing the test down, and the test results are being compiled in a book that is our unique book, our kitab. Iqra kitabak, read your own kitab. This is what you used to do. On the day of judgment, we will see the test results in our own book that we have written with the help of the kiram and katibin. How is success defined in the test? How do we score an A or a B? This is the only test in the entire existence where the results are not dependent upon the effort, are not dependent upon the actual outcome, but rather on the effort that is put in. Every test in this world, you are judged on the outcome. In the test of Allah, it's not the outcome, it's the input, it's the effort, it's the sincerity. Allah does not care about the output, He cares about your input. He cares about how many hours you studied, how much you put in. That's how you're going to be rewarded. Even if the results didn't turn out the way that you thought they would turn out. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ وَإِنَّمَا لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مَا نَوَى. Everybody will get what they intended for. And everyone, their deeds are in accordance with their intention. If you try your best and you still fail, Allah Azza wa Jalla knows you put in your 110% and you will get the full result and the full deed. What examiner will do this? There are people who study the whole semester and for whatever reason on the day of the exam they don't feel well and they score poorly because the outcome wasn't good. And there are those who didn't study at all, but they just happen to know the exam's answers on that day and they get full results. Not so in the test of Allah. The test of Allah is the sincerity. It is the ikhlas, it is the effort, it's how much you put in. Even if for whatever reason you failed in the output, Allah is forgiving and He will see you had the input. And this is of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The success of the test is dependent upon the input and the sincerity and not necessarily the outer output that others might see. How about if we miss a quiz? How about if we missed an assignment? Is there something we can do to make up? Yes, wallahi, there is. In fact, not just one thing. No, in the test of life, in the test of this religion, in the test that Allah has placed upon us, He has given us not one, not dozens, not hundreds, thousands of mechanisms to make up shortcomings, to make up a missing assignment, to make up a past grade that wasn't that good. If we failed in one phase of our life, if we fell short in a previous test of last year or yesterday or when we were young, no problem. The way to get extra points, the way to get extra assignments is unlimited. We can go on and on and on. And subhanallah, all you need to do is to say, I am sorry, please give me some grades. Ya Rab, I committed a sin, forgive me. That in and of itself is making up for a test. That in and of itself will get you good grades. What professor is there that if you go to him and say, I am sorry, please forgive me, he's going to give you an A on the spot? What professor is there that is worthy of being a professor that simply because the student says, I am sorry, forgive me, he will get an A? Not so in this world. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you turn to Him, you show remorse, you are showing your tawbah, you are showing your nadama, your regret, you raise your hands, you say, Ya Rab, you are the Ghafoor, I have fallen short, I want your forgiveness, Ya Rab. Simply acknowledging this will get you positive, will get you grades, and you will pass the test if that is your constant attitude. So many things can be done that can give you extra credit. Sitting in the masjid doing dhikr will give you credit. Reading Quran will give you credit. Going for hajj makes you back to zero as if you have an A from the beginning. There are things you can do that the entire lifetime of your D's and F's will be wiped away just because of one deed. Allah has given so many opportunities for us to get extra credit. Every single day we have the opportunity to get bonus points. Even those that are scoring an A in the test of life, they can get A++++. They can get to the highest level by doing extra credit. The doors of extra credit are unlimited because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to pass the test. He doesn't want us to fail. How about the exam? When does the test finish? Every exam has to have a finishing point. The exam finishes for every one of us when we see the angel of death. That is when the books are shut and the pens are lifted. When we see the angel of death, our test comes to an end. We don't know when that is going to be. Those that are prepared for the exam, those that have studied the syllabus, those that know this is an exam and they're passing every single day, when they see the angel of death, they will rejoice and they will leave with happiness. And those that wasted their life, did not study or act upon the syllabus, did not listen to the teacher, when they see the proctor come, when they see the angel of death come, what will they say? They will say what every student says when the proctor in the exam comes. Give me some more time. I'm not ready right now. Give me another 10-20 minutes. قَالَ رَبِّ ارْجِعُونِي لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِي مَا تَرَكْتُ. He will say to the angel, try to negotiate. Let me go back. Give me some more time. I promise I will pass the test. كلا. That's not going to happen. When the time comes, the time comes. And every single one of us, our time has been predetermined, and Allah Azza wa Jal will not change that. When will the results be given? When are the results shown of the test? Well, the results are shown on the day of examination, on the day of tests, on the day of Yawm al-Hisab and Yawm al-Jaza. It is called the day of Hisab. It is called the day of Jaza. It is called the day of Yawm al-Din. Because on that day, the results are going to be announced. On that day, everybody will know the results of this test. And Allah Azza wa Jal will say, Ya ibadi, O my servants, in hiya illa a'malukum. The test results are your own efforts. If you find good, then thank Allah. And if you find other than that, then blame none other than yourselves. This is also the time when, like everybody, when their exam results come, they check over the tests, they see what they have done. We too are going to see that book on that day. We are going to see that book, and the people who got right exam and correct answers, what happens when you get your exam back and you've scored the correct result? You go and you say to your friend, hey look, I got the score. Allah says in the Quran, هَاُ مُقْرَأُ كِتَابِيَ. Come look, this is my kitab. Look at the score that I got. He's going to be happy. He's going to be rejoicing. He's going to be walking amongst his family and friends because he scored the perfect score. He was prepared for the exam and he had the right results. So he will be happy like every single person is happy when they pass a test. And when the person who failed the test gets the test results back, what do? They slither away. They slink away. They're not with the crowd. They're not happy and rejoicing. No, the one who fails on that day, he will put his result behind his back. وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِهِ. He's going to hide it. He's going to want to pretend he's not there. He will wish, يَا لَيْتَنِي كُنْتُ تُرَابًا. He will wish he never existed. But that wish will not get him anywhere. And his existence will not be wiped out simply because he wanted it to do so. What are the results of failing the test? What happens when you fail this test? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. Those whose scales are light, they are the ones who have failed themselves. خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. They failed themselves. Allah says in the Quran, ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينُ. That is the worst failure. Allah says in the Quran, they are the one خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَهْلِهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. They lost themselves and they lost their families on the day of Qiyamah. There is no worse loss than that loss. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينُ. There is no loss and there is no failure worse than the failure of failing the exam of this world and the exam of our existence. How about passing? What happens when we pass? Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ. Whoever saves himself from the fire of hell and enters Jannah, that is the one who has won. He has passed. He is the one who is successful. Allah says in the Quran, ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْمُبِينَ. That is the manifest passing, the manifest victory. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ. That is the biggest passing. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْكَبِيرُ. That is the massive victory. There is no victory bigger than the victory of passing this test. Because once we pass this test, we will enter Jannat al-Na'im. We will enter a garden that will never finish its delights. We will enter into the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَرِضْوَانُ مِنَ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ. To get the pleasure of Allah is better than getting Jannah. And that is the ultimate pass and the ultimate test. Those who pass this test shall enter everlasting Jannah. And Allah's pleasure will be upon them. And they will get to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no exam more important than the exam of this world. There is no exam whose consequences of failing are more significant and detrimental than this exam. And there is no exam whose passing is more important for us and for our families than the exam of this world. So dear brothers and sisters, pay attention to this exam. You are being tested right now and I am being tested right now. The test is right now in place. Every one of us, we are now being tested. And we will be tested every minute and every hour and every day and every week and every month and every year that we are breathing. And every single minute we have the opportunity to gain extra points and to get hasanat and to wipe away any mistakes that we have. So the one who's conscious of this test will inshallah ta'ala pass it. Why? Because Allah Azza wa Jal wants us to pass. يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَن يَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ. Allah wants to accept your tawbah. Allah wants to guide you. Allah wants to give you blessings. But we are the ones who are not wanting to pass. So many amongst amongst us, turn to Allah, be interested in passing, show that you care about the test, and inshaAllah ta'ala, if you do so, then you will pass the test, because it is custom made just for you, and Allah knows the test that you and only you can pass. May Allah Azza wa Jalla bless me and you with and through the Quran, and may He make us of those who its verses they understand and applies halal and haram throughout our lifespan. I ask Allah's forgiveness. You as well ask Him, for He is the Ghafoor and the Rahman.